Hey guys, press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Pink Villa.
Hi, I'm Surveen Chawla and you're watching me on Pink Villa.
Hi, this is Rajeev Khandelwal and this is Pink Villa. So we are very glad to be here today. We both are part of a beautiful series called Haq Se, which will start streaming very soon. Haq Se is a story about four sisters. It's based on a book called Little Women. And for me, I'm very, very fortunate and happy to be a part of this series. The series was narrated to me, I think in March last year. And from the moment I heard it, I wanted to be a part of it in however small measure. But then it was very important for me to be a part of it because this is a classic and it has turned out to be a classic.
So honestly, I haven't read the classic book, Little Women. But from people who have read the book, normally, you know, it's very difficult to translate a good book on screen. And people who've seen the book and who are a part of the show, part of the series in some way or the other, whether it's in front of the camera or without, from what we've done, and now that finally it's time for it to come out and we've had the trailer launch, think that the job has been done pretty well.
So I think, you know, initially the working title was Mirza Sisters.
Mirza Girls.
It was Mirza Girls. And then Ekta has this whole thing for titles. I think she generally comes up with the apt title at the appropriate moment. And I think just about 6 months back or maybe 7 months back, we were told that the shoot, it's called Haq Se. And it took me a while to move from Mirza Sisters to Haq Se, and now it just sounds so apt and so appropriate for the series. And I think
Haq Se gives you a more general or a more larger overview of what the show is, because it's not just the opinions and the dreams and the ambitions and the goals and the rights of the women, yeah, but it's per se the lives of the people that they have to live in a place like
it has a deeper
meaning to, and it gives that to the show, you know. For example, words like you know, the nuktas in the nukta and the kha in the nukta also it's just a very, very beautiful language actually. And it was a lot of fun using these nuktas here and there. For example, words like khandan became khandan and not khandan, and khala, and these nuktas only make you feel, they're so elegant and so beautiful that I think we had a lot of fun working on the dialect and the diction, and while we were shooting actually. Sometimes you would khur the khala, but that's okay.
Also, the characters based in this series they come from a very progressive today's family. So it's not about Kashmiris living in small parts of Kashmir.
Yeah.
This family is settled in Srinagar, educated family. Yeah, we really didn't have to go deep into the Kashmiri language. It's about people, and people like us who we meet every day on a day-to-day basis in Mumbai or any other metros.
It's very spoken language. Even the Urdu is very spoken Urdu, so you won't feel that much of a difference.
So I walked for about 5 kilometers, and I told these guys that fetch me or pick me up on your way, and I'll get into the car. It will be my morning run also. And I ended up walking for about 16 kilometers, walking and running for 16 kilometers. And everyone thought, you know, that Rajeev is angry and he has left. And nobody knew that I was enjoying the whole place. You know, by the time, say, about 13 or 14 kilometers of running and walking, and so I started getting calls, and the production came to me and they said, Rajeev sir, we are really sorry. We know that you are angry. And I said, no, I'm not angry, but I kept walking, and no car came to pick me up. And then somebody asked me that, sir, now, for the sake of others, for the sake of the production, please feign anger. So I was feigning anger on the set also that the car didn't come. So I was like running all the way for 16 kilometers, but actually I was just doing that to maintain myself. So hi, this is Rajeev Khandelwal, and this is of course the beautiful Surveen Chawla.
Thank you.
And we are going to be victims of this game called the Truth Bomber.
And Pinkvilla is fishing for some interesting answers from us.
We do not know what the questions are, and let's see what question do I get. Married life or singlehood? Now, give me some more time, maybe, you know, some more married years, and then probably I'll answer this question. Right now, married life is really beautiful.
Okay, then. Hated a scene, but had to do it. You guys are smart and how. Hated a scene. There is a scene, so Meher, which is my character, she's, because of the conditioning that she's had living in Kashmir and in the patriarchal society that she's been brought up, she is a conformist of sorts. So she's not a feminist. For her, if things go wrong or if a woman is treated badly, for her it comes around and she thinks, "Arre, but it's the woman who's responsible. She must have done something, but this is how men are. And women must be more careful about things and more cautious about things." That to me does not come naturally because I'm not a conformist. I'm a feminist who believes in equality. I mean, feminism has gone to another level today where we're going into the extremes of the definition of the word. It's not vindictiveness at all. It's not putting men down. It's just fighting for or just voicing your own opinions about where you want to stand and the fact that you want to stand next to them. So there have been scenes, not one, but to just play that part for me, everywhere that would have to come out in a scene where Meher thinks it's the woman, who's on the wrong side of things, was very, very difficult because that's not me. It was hard to do that.
Will you dance at a wedding for $1 million? No, I will not.
Why are you getting on wedding questions?
I don't know. No, I will not dance for $1 million at a wedding.
A billion?
No, not even for 10 rupees, not even for 10 billion, nothing. I don't believe that I have dancing capabilities to do dance at any wedding.
Okay. Will you strip for a show or a movie? Okay, so the strip is not the right word to use.
Yeah.
So I've done a film called Parched that had nudity in the film. And, you know, it's like how you say that, you know, as teenagers, when we probably must have had our first kiss, there is a nervousness, you know, and you don't know how that feels. The only thing I felt before doing those particular scenes was that bit of nervousness, and I'm not somebody who's actually inhibited at all. In fact, it was an extremely liberating experience, and it actually corrected for me the difference between, and the fact that there is a difference between nudity and nakedness. So when you speak of the word strip has a naked connotation to it, while nudity is a form of art. And yes, I'm not inhibited by stripping, but it's not stripping,
yeah,
so to
too,
say.
I mean,
it's
too strong a
word to use, no. It has to have the right context, and it has to be in the aesthetic sense of the project or the script, have a very integral role to play in the film. So yeah.
Got caught while in action. Which action are we talking about? Obviously action or
I'm sure as a teenager, come on.
I'm very secretive when it comes to all these things.
Which is why the question is got caught.
Yeah. No, I don't think anyone has ever caught me in action. Ever. Barring the directors, probably.
Role you regret doing? No, nothing at all. I'm very proud of all the work that I've done and always will be. And in fact, I don't regret anything in life. Okay, so what we're doing now is that Pink Filler wants to know how well we know our co-stars, starting from Rajeev to all the wonderful co-actors that we've had on the show. So come on, bring it on, Pink Filler.
Filmy for life. Aanchal.
Oh my God. Yeah. Dadi.
Dadi.
Farida ji.
Oh.
Oh my God. She used to treat us all every single day of the shoot
the
with some
adorable,
amazing,
yeah,
amazing food, and she's a sweetheart. Raji.
Who is that? Ken? No. You looking at me?
No.
No. Can't stomach any
I think Parul.
Secret. I have not really interacted much with her.
So. I have. Parul.
Stalker amongst the two.
Should I give the wrong answer? Should I? Okay. That answer was for this.
Ah. You can repeat yourself. No better stalker.
Sorry. You're going to answer this. Please, come on. I'll sound very mean, okay?
No, they're asking amongst the two of us. Between the two of us.
Between the two of us. Stalker. I don't stalk you, yeah.
Yeah. I you stalked don't? You once when I went for my workout and I was standing outside the room.
He's talked to
probably
me.
Probably I'm yeah, I'm the stalker. Let's give it to Ken. He's been good to almost 100%. Everyone. I think he can stand 100%. For all the actors.
For
yeah.
All, not just the actors, for everybody.
Technicians and everyone.
For
I think
everybody.
Ken. Who sucks at remembering things? The producers. They forgot about a whole lot of things. Karan and Viraj, kidding. Obviously, it will always be the producers because, you know, we always over demand and we always...
You're being extremely candid, Rajeev. Overtly candid.
No. But we generally, you know, we trouble all the producers and the production department. So let's say production department.
That's the actor's job, yeah. To trouble the producers, yeah. And the producers to get troubled. So you can't say
that. Let's be safe on that one. So let's put it on the production that... They would forget. Sir, we said that you called call time 9 o'clock. You called call time 9 o'clock. Yeah.
But that's all your habit. So the producers, good job. If you guys enjoyed our conversation with Pink Filler, please like, share and subscribe to Pink Filler.
Thank you.